At our summer camps, we'd play softball at night. They'd have volleyball. She beat all the boys in softball. She'd volleyball. If the boys hit the ball 400 yards, she hit it 600. If they caught it underhanded, she caught it underhanded twice and did whatever. Her abilities in the motor skilled athletes, athletic events, unbelievable. And she just transferred that eventually to bowling, and she's matured to that point.
One-time wonder,
right,
or a fluke, you know, a throwback that we keep for a year, then we throw it back to the other fish. No, for me to succeed will be gaining exemption for the following season, but ultimately I want to win a title. And after talking to Dick and, you know, telling me some of the things that I'm really good at, my pure swing, my tendency just to come at the ninth and tenth frame and have that sweet, relaxed swing, that's going to give me the advantage. And again, it's not ego. It's not cockiness, it's just that confidence that
you can win that,
that I can win.
Jerry with his briefcase.
This was her last shot, and I mean, I think we both knew it. When they ended the women's tour, there was a very deep sadness in Kelly. I mean, the other women moved on, Kelly could not. She was very sad.
What do you mean the other moved on?
Well, the first year I thought, you know, I was the one that suggested she go work for her father because the women's tour ended. I thought, give it a year, 6 months, they'll be back. These are women bowler, people like them. And it didn't happen. And we went to the Queens, and one girl's teaching, the other one's grooming dogs, the other one's flipping houses in California. They all found something to do, and they were happy. Kelly wasn't happy, you know, and she was practicing, and I'm thinking, for what? Then she started doing these men's regionals. When the men invited the women in, she started doing the men's regionals. And I thought, you know, okay, if you make a check, it covers your expenses, but you're working so hard for so little.
So you didn't expect much to happen?
No, I knew she could make money at it, but I didn't think this was a future. And I mean, you work for your dad, so you can take Friday off to travel, and you can come in late on Monday and take off 2 afternoons a week and go practice. It's the perfect job. But with what we pay her, she's eligible for food stamps. I mean, really, seriously.
It seems like women entering men's sports right now has got a lot of hype. And hopefully the hype that Kelly, you know, is coming out to play against the men, as well as Danica Patrick came on the Indy Race Car League, you know, a year or two ago. It just seems like those two sports have thrived because of that. So hopefully bowling can do the same.
She started with us as a bowler when she was 13 or 14, went through the camp 4 or 5 years. When she was 17, I and my staff saw some tremendous ability in her as a person, her personality, communication, and so on. And so we interned her, we mentored her, that's a 2-year program, and we gave her the coach training program, which we teach. And then we put her on staff, and she's been with us for 11 years teaching. And she comes back every year, just like most of my staff does for the 4 to 5 weeks in the summer here in upstate New York, and they're on the staff full-time teaching. She loves it.
Very good question. David said, when you turn your feet as well? When you start off and you find when you're standing square and you turn slightly, your hips will still be square. Then as you move right or left, we don't call or say that it's a pivot, but when we turn slightly, our shoulders and hips and our feet are going to follow. So instead of thinking of it as a pivot, it's just now a turn. Notice where that turn is and always go through that process. I feel that I have to be a step or two ahead. I have to be clever. I can't always rely on power because I'm not as strong as most of the men out there. Okay. So I have to be clever and accurate. If I can stay 1 or 2 steps ahead of them, then I'll always be equal with them or even slightly ahead of them.
I don't understand the men's games, and I don't understand the oil patterns. Mm-hmm. But with the women, we would psychologically, like, who's afraid of you? Who knows you can beat them?
I see. So you help, really helped with kind of psychological strategy.
I don't bowl. I have a 90. This year, I think I have a 94 average.
Right.
So I can help her with her game.
Right.
But I do help. When? All right. When Kelly was 16, she had been to Dick Richter for quite a few years. And so had a lot of other people. And we know, no, maybe she was a little younger. Maybe she was 14 or 15. And we noticed everybody throws the way Dick Richter taught them. So I said, Kelly, you all know how to bowl. So now it's a question of who wants it more, mm-hmm. who's mentally ready, who's mm-hmm. hungrier for it. Mm-hmm. So from about 15 on, we started making her mental game much more important.
When you say we?
Her and I discussed
okay.
it.
You discussed it.
I would get tired.
Yeah.
Yeah. When I was at my weakest or most tired or most fatigued, she's like, all right, this is now when you bowl one more.
Yeah.
Because if you can get through another game, it's, again, going to yeah. help you through the long run.
Bills, you're red.
So that's, yeah. that was
Are you
our
tired?
Plan.
Are you so tired you can't stand up anymore? Yeah. She'd say, yeah, it's okay, go bowl one more.
Yeah, and I'd find know. That extra bit of energy, you know,
Pull
just to get
out.
Through, to work hard enough to, all right, one more game, let me bring my energy level back up and get through it, and that might be the edge I need.
I was your biggest supporter.
Yeah.
Sorry, I just winked at her.
One of the supporters, right?
What's that?
One of the supporters.
Yes, yes.
So how did it go? How was the communication through your mom? How did it
Well, actually, when Kelly went off to college, we used to talk. Kelly used to call home. I actually, she used to call me and my husband. I don't live at home anymore. And then I would hear through my mom. And, you know, Kelly did so many great things. I used to read about it in all the papers. So I was a groupie.
She was very focused on exactly everything that she did, and she had goals. Even at that age, she had goals, and her attention span was excellent. She really worked and strived for everything she got.
So do you think that makes her really great bowler? That's the biggest variable is attention span?
Exactly. You have to. Absolutely. You have to have self-discipline and that drive, a certain quality about a person that makes you special.
I can call any of them at a drop of a hat, whether it's 2 in the morning or 6 o'clock in the morning, and they'll be willing to talk to me and help me through whatever it is I'm having trouble with.
But Richard, you have a special relationship going.
Richard's like my second father. He is. We just kind of connected when I was younger. You know, I made the comment to him when he made the comment that I was the 12-year-old girl, drinks coffee with the instructors in the morning, half sugar, half milk, you know, somewhat, yeah. some milk, you know. He loves the same music I do. He's taught me how to golf. You know, he's taught me a little bit about gambling in a positive way and how to have a little bit of fun.
Right.
But he's been, just like my mom, he's been another supporter. He's been someone I can call up and vent to. I come up and visit him once or twice a year, and I practice at the center that he works at so I can train and have another pair of eyes behind me. But he's a very comfortable figure, someone that I can be myself around. And
we're the same, and the beauty of being involved at our end is this. Every person, we have doctors, lawyers, clean the street, whatever, they're all here. And guess what? When they bowl a strike, they feel this emotion. And when they throw a ball not too good, they feel this emotion. And everybody has gone through those same emotions in bowling. And so we all know that, so we know what they go through. It isn't like, we're all the same.
When Kelly was growing up and my kids were growing up, we didn't have soccer and karate and tai chi. The thing you did on a Saturday morning was went bowling. They had bowling leagues 3 times a day because there were so many kids that bowled. And that's what you did when they were younger.
It's kind of towards middle, but it's still the average person. It's the average person.
Actually, I hated bowling. When I would visit Nancy in the bowling center, it was filled with smoke. There were guys high-fiving her and drinking and having their hands all over her. So I had a very negative initial view of bowling. 2 years ago, we went through the empty nest syndrome. Our last daughter moved out. And we became aware of the fact that we did very little together. And bowling is Nancy's passion. And so I decided that I would start up bowling so that we would have something in common.
This is my sister's truck. My father, when he first bought this, they asked him, you know, Jennifer's, oh, can it be my truck and so forth? And they put her name on the side of the door. So to this day, it's still Jennifer's truck.
We all worked with our dad at some time. I think I'm my father's son that he never had. So we're all well versed in the auto body business. So yes, I drove that tow truck many times, towed many cars, plowed many snowstorms. So and now Kelly has the reins down there.
Yeah, we're all very independent. If anything ever happened to their husbands or so forth, we could, each and every one of us could take care of ourselves. That's all I ever wanted was to bowl professionally. So.
Like your whole life kind of changed at that moment.
Well, again, working here was just able to bring me closer to my dad.
Where's the Kios? I try to talk Spanish too, you know? El Kios. Suavecito. Suavecito, he knows. Llave, Kios. You know how to speak Spanish? I'm learning. I put an El Hamburger O. I put a Pepsi Cola O.
Daddy, you need help?
No, I'm good, baby. I'm doing a friend of mine a favor, you know?
Taking the brakes off, or what?
Just doing this. I'm just trying to say.
Oh, the fuel pump, right?
Yeah, this is the fuel filter. I don't know if...
My husband knows nothing. God bless him, the guy knows nothing about bowling. Just wants to know how much money's in it. So she's bowling with a Brunswick bowling ball, and she rolls 300, and the people sitting in back of her are the woman who ran the program and two guys from Brunswick. So I call my husband on the phone, I'm saying, Kelly just rolled a 300 the first time in 36 years. She rolled a 300, and she's throwing a Brunswick ball, and the guys from Brunswick are there. So my other daughter, Jackie, the middle daughter, calls up the next day and said, Daddy said, Kelly rolled a 300 against a 36-year-old woman from New Brunswick.
Mixing paint? Jackie taught me that, my sister.
That's it, shut it off!
Yeah, she used to do it for my dad.
Guess what was the matter? The Mongolo had no gas in it. Stupid Mongolo.
This is when you put too much in that
fucking
you have to
Mongolo.
Filter it out.
You know what a Mongolo is? It's the guy that owns his car, Mongolo. We want to take the motor and transmission out. Eddie want to do that. These are going to do a documentary. We're going to have an Orange County motorcycle. You know Orange County Chopper? It's going to be KBF Chopper Body Shop. All right, buddy.
You discouraged?
No, I'm going to take a little break. I got a bad finger. I smashed my finger.
Yeah.
I opened this garage door and I went to shut the door. You see how the lips are in there like that? And I thought I was in one of those lips that weren't closing. And I stuck my hand in one and I pulled the door down and snapped it like a chicken bone. Just like a chicken bone. Oh, it hurt. I saw God. I come running over here and I stuck my hand in my car in the trunk with the ice water. And then Eddie took me to the hospital.
You know how that feels.
They don't do shit in the hospital. You know, you sit there and wait, you could be dying. Some lady there, she can't pass a bar. She got a pain in her stomach. She's in the emergency room. You know, and I'm standing, I don't know where to go, what to do. It's two people. One girl said I got a sore throat. The other girl said I got abdominal pains. And I'm here, boom, banging, you know what I mean? And I'm rubbing. Yeah, and then it went away. I was all right. They gave me an ice pack and that was it. What'd George say?
He said the gas gauge has never been wrong. So he said he feels foolish about what happened.
Yeah, well.
So I said, well, you'll call him back.
No big deal. I feel foolish. Too lucky we didn't do that. All I did was take the fuel filter off, which is, you know. And I would have swore, I would have bet my life it was the fuel filter because he never changed it. As soon as I blew through it and got gas, that was it. You all right, Paco?
Oh, yeah, she was good. Anything she did, she was good at.
Yeah.
I was too young for it, though. Yeah.
And did you pick up, do you follow her bowling career at all?
I've seen her on ESPN, a couple times.
How do you kind of feel when you say I know her?
Yeah, I like it.
No, when?
I feel happy, yeah.
So, can you see the transition from a 12-year-old to a 20-year-old?
Oh, yeah, big difference.
What's the difference besides size?
Ponytail's still there.
Technique, stronger. Uh-huh. She's more mature.
What about the mental?
She's got it upstairs. Yeah.
Was she determined then? When
she
was younger, so
sort of
discipline?
Yeah, she was disciplined. She, whatever she wanted to do, she did it.
Well, you seem to take pleasure in her presence.
Yeah. Every time I see her, I say, hi, Kelly. How you doing? How you doing, like, the bowling tour and stuff like that? Do you win me any money? Right?
When am I going to support him?
Yeah.
You bet on
him. Not too old for him.
Hey, Kelly.
Yeah.
Kelly's coming. Watch out, guys.
Yeah.
What did that mean?
Just watch out for her. That's what it means.
Oh, okay. But years ago, you were around then years ago?
Too? Tony bowls.
Are you bowl?
I used to go watch a bowl all the time.
Uh-huh.
But I used to go down the field on the Thursday night.
Yeah.
I stopped and watched the bowl. She blew my mind, boy.
Yeah.
She got some technique. I wish I had that.
She gets slapped down. You know what I mean? Like,
no, I don't.
She doesn't get a big head.
Right.
You know, she doesn't come home and everybody's saying, wow, you threw a 300. They're looking at her like, what does that mean, you know? So it keeps her humble. It really does. The fact that we kind of totally ignore her when she's home. Like when she won. She won the tour trials, drove home, and the next morning got up and went to work.
Mm-hmm.
And she's talking to a reporter on the newspaper, and my husband's yelling at her, go pick up the pizza. So it kind of keeps her grounded,
mm-hmm.
you know, and I like that.
But I never try to be better than anybody. Because any sport, there's always, you look at all the greats of the past and what they did to get there, number one. How long they stay there, and then it's just a matter of time before someone's right behind them on their skirt tails, and they end up passing them and they're number one in the world. So it's like now, I'm going to enjoy this while it lasts. But there's somebody 5 years younger than me that's on the same track I am and wants to accomplish the same thing that soon will pass me. So I guess maybe that's where I put it into terms. That's how it's a reality for me, that it's not always gonna be that way. So, and like Richard said, it can't, you know? Accept the things that I cannot change and change the things that I can and look at it that way.
This is a moronic design. Some moron invented this shit. Look at this shit.
We'll make it
look easy. Oh, God. Oh, my. I cut the sumbitch off with an axle.
Yeah.
In a way, he's teaching me how to work on cars, and I'm teaching him the technology that he's missing. Yeah. So it evens out. There's a purpose to his madness.
Well, it's actually important that you're here,
though. Oh, yeah. It's funny. I was in Illinois one day. And I just did a skit for Ebonite, and my dad called me up. And here I am, you know, 900 miles away, and he's asking me, how do I print this document? And I'm walking him through trying to print this document, and the woman in the car is just laughing hysterical. Because, you know, printing a document is so easy nowadays. But for my dad, it's a task.
The way you think it's kind of protective of it.
Am I? Yeah. We all are. All my sisters are. You know? We know that he knows a lot of things about cars, but there's other things that we have to bring him to reality on. You know, we have to bring him into our world sometimes and figure out, you know, well, Dad, how do I do this and so forth? He's like, well, what are you doing this for? I'm like, and then you explain it to him, then he understands.
You know, I like to get the guy that made this and choke him. That would be nice, you know what I mean? The guy that made this gas can't choke him with it.
You know more about body shop than your dad knows about
bowling?
He seems to have this world. This is his world.
Yeah. Hmm? And that's how I get close to him. I come into his world.
Well, that's what I was just saying, that I'm his daughter's come to work here. So he can connect with you.
Yeah.
With him.
My dad lives in his own world.
Lives in his own world.
He's got the world. He's got the body shop, the boat, and food.
Yeah, that's it.
And oxygen is the other important thing.
our parents always pushed us to do whatever we wanted to do. It was never, you know, anything girly. I mean, I don't think any of us ever played with Barbie dolls. We were never Barbie girls, you know. We all more were, I wouldn't call us all tomboys, but, you know, we all did sports that boys did, you know, basketball, baseball. I mean, Kelly played Little League baseball, you know, and then went into softball and things like that. And, yeah, I think my father had some influence with, you know, the body shop, because that's where his love is, you know. And if we wanted to spend a lot of time with him, we did that. We went fishing, down to the boat, and spent a lot of time with our grandparents and, you know, just did that kind of stuff.
Question I wanted to ask you, when you build a 300 perfect game, was the first time you've done that?
In the PBA, yes.
Okay, what was that feeling?
That was...
It
just gave me, like, a boost.
Were you in, like, in a zone when you were doing that?
Yeah. I didn't look at the score monitor or anything.
Uh-huh.
And someone had said I bumped out at the top 10, I fell out. So it gave me a little cushion.
Right.
It gave me a little room to breathe.
Right.
And not have to worry about so much about trying to shoot 240 every game. So
what was that feeling of the zone when you had it?
Twice during that week I had the front 10.
Yeah.
So when I finally did it, it was like, yes, I finally got the monkey off my back, you know, and I finally shot 300. Finally through 12 in a row.
It's about making it.
You know,
winning, getting enough points, and surviving. And then we'll all sit back and let her support us.
Yeah, my father wants a new boat.
Oh,
wow. I want a thousand at the Atlantic City.
There's a $1,000 slot machine in Borgata.
Right.
And I have this fantasy. I have three fantasies. I'll tell you what my three dreams are. I want to fly first class somewhere, which Kelly could pay for that now for me. I want a brand new out of the car showroom, which he could pay for. And I want to be able to walk up, sit down at the $1,000 slot machine in Borgata and drop in two chips. And that's, you know, nobody will pay for that, but an idiot. Then I'd have to steal her money at night while she's asleep.
Not as tight and as cheap as
okay.
I am, as she's claiming.
So, if you ever see me play in a $1,000 slot machine, you'll know Kelly won. You
and I'd like a jacuzzi. Jennifer, Jerry, what's your request? College for the girls?
Yeah.
Wait a second, I want to change mine.
Three college for the girls.
Or a hot tub, let's
three
be
weddings
honest.
In our future.
Three weddings in the college.
Yeah, Jeff, you bet you're smart. College and a wedding.
You got to start bowling with both hands.
Yeah. And my father wants a new boat.
Yep. Yeah.
What's it called, Dad?
A Bertram.
Enriquez?
Yeah.
30 footer?
35.
Yeah, what's 400,000?
Where's that place up towards
Massachusetts? Those are the requests.
When they talk about the hunger in the belly, that they always say, that's what she has. But she's been like it since she was little.